Hey, hello everyone, what is cooking all you good looking people out there, and welcome to another exciting episode of GeoGuessr. Here we are in yesterday's daily challenge location. Oh, what a nice spot. We got beautiful, beautiful views, clouds and islands, and wow. I mean, this is the kind of place I'd like to go explore, that's for sure. But the real question is, where in the world are we? And I'm not really sure. I mean, there's this, I don't know what this is, the foundation for something. I think we're in the Pacific, but I haven't really figured where I think we are. I was thinking maybe like around over here. Where's Tahiti? Maybe Fiji. No, you know what? Let's go here. Let's go to the Galapagos. Let's say we're like, right around over here or something. Make the guess, and the answer was, no, it was just Brazil. I mean, there you go. Just Brazil right over here, actually, near a pretty big city. Well, I gotta say, I'm surprised with that, but there you go, 1373. Hopefully some of you guys figured that one out. Alright, here we are in the main section of today's video. And today, oh man, and by main section, I mean daily challenge, but I'm not re-recording that because I said the wrong words, because I say it pretty much every day. Here we are in today's daily challenge, and ooh, this is actually pretty cool. Look at this, nice hotel. Looks pretty high-tech, got the hotel staff over there making everything ready. I mean, sure, yeah, it's moist, it's wet, it's not, you know, the ideal weather, but, you know, look at this. There's like a pool you can walk on. I mean, that's pretty cool, right? You know, I like that. You could be like Chris Angel walking on water. It's magic. I mean, you could tell, you know, you're not walking on water, but yeah, it's close enough to a magic trick for me. And yeah, this looks nice. I wonder where in the world we are. Well, that is where you guys come in. All you need to do is put your guesses down in the comment section below. Tell me where in the world you think this is. And in tomorrow's video's comment section, I announce the winner, the person that guesses closest. Now, there are no prizes, but there is glory to be won. So if you are interested in becoming today's top GeoGuessr, then tell me, where in the world do you think we are right now? Alright, here we are in the main section of today's video, and today we've got a viewer challenge brought to us by none other than our good friend, Lance and Derek. That's right, Lance and Derek, thank you so much for sending this one in, and this challenge has a very cool theme. It is the largest concerts ever. These are the five locations around the world that hosted the five largest music concerts in history, from the fifth largest to the largest ever. There's a small bit of info below on each location, so I have my phone with me, and I'm going to, after we make a guess, look at each location and talk a little bit about it. Very cool. Now, very nice. Thank you so much, Lance and Derek, for sending this one in. If you are interested in creating your own custom challenge, all you need to do is look down in the description below, find a step-by-step guide on how to create your own custom challenge and how to send it to me. Also, you find a link to this one so you can play along yourself. So let's go ahead and do so. Challenge accepted. All right, and we start off in none other than Germany. That's my guess. My guess is we start off in Germany. Where? Dortmund. Oh, yeah, it is Germany. And Dortmund is one of those places near the big three, right? It's right over here. Okay, so we start off near Dortmund. Well, it's a big music festival here, apparently. What kind of music do I think played there? I don't know. Maybe it's I bet you it's like a big metal concert or something like that, right? Maybe it's a big Madonna concert. Who knows? Chances are this is probably a multiple artist type of concert, like a, you know, because that's what most of these are, right? These are the biggest ever. But, you know, the biggest ever is not going to be a single artist. It's going to be, you know, multiple artists and things like that. And then I guess, you know what, I guess I'll also rank which one of these I would rather go to out of the five. So I'm going to say which one I'd rather go to. Maybe we'll get, you know, some information about who played there. Although, there you go, Germany. I mean, I'll be honest with you, at this point, having not really thought much about what the chances, which ones they are. I mean, having said that I've been to the biggest music festival out there, I don't know if that necessarily is something that I'm like, oh, I'm super pumped about. Let's return to still location and see. Do I think that, no, it wasn't necessarily right around here. I was wondering if maybe we were like really close to it or something like that, but it doesn't look like it. Like the music happened here. I mean, this is, it probably just happened in the city somewhere in Dortmund. Well, let's call it like right here or something like that. Would I like to say that I've been to the biggest music concert ever? No, not really. It really will just depend which city that it's in. But we're gonna find out. I mean, let's find out a little bit more about this one. This one was actually really close to right in the middle. That's where we were. It was probably right in this park or something like that. But let's find out. First is the Bundesstraße 1 in Dortmund, where the Love Parade, Highway of Love, was held in 2008. The concert was focused on electronic dance music. All right. That sounds like fun. Electronic dance music. And it said in the title, it was held on a highway. It was held on a highway. Wow. Okay. And attracted a crowd of 1.6 million people. Wow. 1.6 million people showed up to this on a highway to listen to EDM. All right, I like it. Would I have liked to go on the highway and listen to electronic dance music? Maybe. Maybe I would have liked that. Let's find out where the next one is. Let's make our choices. Let's see. Oh, this place looks interesting. This is going to be in. I don't know where this is going to be. This is going to be in. In Spain, Portugal, in PL, Poland, in Poland. Poland, really? This is Poland. I don't know about that. Maybe this. Okay, I'm just gonna ignore everything I'm seeing here and just move on. I don't know where we are. Italy, Italy. We're in Italy. Okay, we are in Italy. That makes a lot of sense. That tour bus, we're just gonna straight up ignore it. Didn't help us at all. We are in Italy, and where in Italy are we? Well, we could be in Rome. We could be in other places, but I'm thinking we are in, I'm thinking we are in Rome, actually. Maybe there was like a big concert filled up the Colosseum, but that would be like 50,000 people at most. I don't know how big it is, but that wouldn't be like millions of people. 1.6 million people on a highway. That's insane. Hopefully there were no cars. Because, well, I mean, there definitely weren't. There was. That would have been a. That wouldn't have ended so well. Is this where the Illuminati hangs out? Definitely. Look at this. This is definitely where the Illuminati hangs out. Because, I mean, where else could we be? Okay, so Naples is down there. So yeah, we are in Rome because Naples is really close to Rome. Is it? Is it close to Rome? Well, I mean, sort of. So we're in Rome somewhere. That is interesting. A big concert in Rome, right near this Illuminati pyramid. All right, let's make the guess. Let's find out about it. So, second is the Circus Maximus in Rome, where the band Genesis played when in Rome 2007. It attracted a crowd of 2 million people. Genesis played in Rome in 2007 to a crowd of 2 million people. That's a single band. Wow. That is insane. Now, which one would I rather? The highway concert or the Rome concert? I'd rather the Rome concert. I mean, what Genesis hits do I like? Do I like any of Genesis's songs? Let's find out. Well, I probably spelt it wrong right there, isn't it? With the Genesis band. All right. What do we got? We got some big hits. What's your number one hit? I know I just can't think of any other songs off the top of my head. Okay, well, you know what? It's not gonna help. All right. Whatever. It's not gonna help. I'm gonna go with Genesis. I think that's gonna be a more fun time in Rome. 6345. All right, what about this place? A lions and we're gonna be in, oh geez, I don't know where we're gonna be. Are we gonna be in Germany again? We could be. Could be in Germany. Or we could be in France. All right, we could be in France somewhere, or not. I don't know. Let's look around. Wow, jeez, look at this place. Oh yeah, this is in France, isn't it? This place is in Paris. At least I'm fairly certain that it is. Oh, don't do that to me. Oh boy, we're in a tunnel. Oh, yeah, this thing. All right, we got to go there. I've seen this thing before. Wow, this place really futuristic. It's always surprising to me that this is in Paris. It doesn't look like Paris to me, but it is, isn't it? This thing. I'm fairly certain I recognize this. Let's move. Oh no, we can't go up. We can go up, and we're gone. I don't know where we are. All right. Well, I'm almost positive that we are, you know, in France, and we're just, you know, looking out. It's a really nice place. Very futuristic. I like it. You know, if I went to France, I'd make sure to visit this area because this place is pretty cool. It'd be cool to work around here, wouldn't it? Right? Have like an apartment, work near this place. Like that'd be pretty awesome, actually. So where is this? This is it's in this area over here of Paris. It's like around this. It's like somewhere around here. Or maybe it's like over here. I don't know. It's in this sort of direction, isn't it? Maybe it's over here. The answer was on the other side of this river. Oh, okay. I see. 6226. Well, let's find out. Would I have rather gone to the Paris concert? The third is where in 1990 electronic music artist Jean-Michel Jarre performed A City in Concert for an audience of 2.5 million people. You know what? I'm going to go for the Rome one because, I don't know, electronic music artist Jean-Michel Jarre. I don't know if that sounds that... I mean, I don't know who this person is. Maybe I'd like it. I mean, I like the area. In 1990, did that area look the same? Maybe it did, maybe it didn't. I have no idea. I'm still going to go for the Genesis concert, although that does intrigue me. It is a location that I like the most. 6226. All right. Well, what about this area over here? Where are we now? We are in Rio. We're in Rio is where we are. Is that possible? I think it's actually quite possible that we are indeed in Rio. In fact, I'd be pretty surprised if we weren't. We could be, you know, not in Rio. You know, I think that is what this is, right? This is that beach. This is that stuff. This is... Now, the real question is, are we... And my real question is, when I look at this place over here, is what we're seeing is we're seeing this beach here, right? I guess so. Or we're seeing this beach here. I don't know which one we're seeing. Or are we at a beach over here? I think we're going to be... This is going to be Copacabana Beach. I think that's what we're seeing. And yeah, that's just what I'm going to guess that it is. I think this is Copacabana Beach. So let's... I mean, look, it looks beautiful, right? It's a huge, huge beach. Absolutely. I mean, it's very, very nice, right? And we definitely are in Brazil. All right, so what do I think, who do I think played at Copacabana Beach? I don't know who I think played at Copacabana Beach at all. We're in Brazil, that's for sure. And the answer is yes, we are indeed there. So who played there? Copacabana Beach in Rio de Janeiro, where Rod Stewart performed for New Year's Eve concert in 1994. It was attended by 3.5 million people. Rod Stewart. You know what? I'd like that. I'd go for a Rod Stewart New Year's Eve concert with 3.5 million people in Brazil. I think that'd be a lot of fun. A New Year's Eve concert. Yeah. All right. I like that. I'm going to go for that. Well, that's going to be my new number one, 6470. I mean, it's a weird one, but hey, why the hell not? And finally, we find ourselves in Moscow. Which is interesting. Do we find ourselves in Moscow? I believe we do. But that's surprising. Biggest concert ever was in Moscow. I wonder who played there. Well, let's find out. 4 million people showed up to this concert. I mean, that's pretty crazy if that's true. Let's go look around. I mean, I don't know. I just said 4 million because it's more than 3.5, so it's the number I'm expecting to see. Maybe it's 3.8. You never know. 300,000 people? Still nothing to sneeze at. 300,000 people is a lot. If there are 300,000 people at, like, a sporting event, that'd be crazy. That'd be a huge crowd. We are indeed in Moscow. I'm fairly certain that's where we are, because that building seemed recognizable enough. And there you go. I mean, that's where we are. So let's make the guess and place us there. Read a little bit about, a little outside of it, but all right. Last location is outside of Moscow, State University, where again, John Michael's Jar. Jeez, this guy's putting some big concerts. Or Jean-Michel Jarre performed for a crowd between 3.5 and 3.7 million. In celebration of the 850th birthday of Moscow. Jean-Michel Jarre, my God, crushing it. For someone I don't know who they are. That's crazy. I'll go for the Paris one instead. But, geez. Yeah, all right. So we're going to rank them. Which one would I rather go to? I'm going to say I would rather go to the Rod Stewart in Rio, because that seems weird. Then... we're going to go for the Rome Genesis concert, then Paris, then, you know what, then let's go for the Moscow one, just because it's the biggest one ever, then the Dortmund one. So there you go. Wow, what a concert. Geez, I wonder if anyone's been to all five. 58.95, and there you go. Started off in Dortmund, then we went to Rome, then we went to Paris, then we went to Rio, then we went to Moscow. 39.06. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this one. I know I certainly have. And as always, I'll see you guys next time.
Aw, yeah. Cue the royalty-free music. 3, 2, 1, go. Come on, everybody. Get on your feet. Stand up, look at the screen, and repeat. I'm gonna like, rate, comment, and subscribe. I love watching AetherVids all of the time. Thanks for dropping by and spending the time. Hope you've enjoyed, and let's get on with our lives. Oh yeah. Thanks to Kevin MacLeod for these awesome beats. Ooh yeah. Have a good one.